Students, today I am going to discuss a reaction in which you can see two named reactions. So first is Staudinger reaction, and now we will see what is this Staudinger reaction. So it is reaction of organic azide with trialkyl or triaryl phosphines offers corresponding azylides, and these azylides are also known as immunophosphorines. And this reaction is known as Staudinger reaction. The reaction is given here, that is organic azide upon reaction with trialkyl or triaryl phosphines, there will be loss of dinitrogen molecule, leads to the formation of azylide or immunophosphorine, and this formation of immunophosphorine by the reaction of organic azide with trialkyl or triaryl phosphine is known as Staudinger reaction. And this Staudinger reaction is also known as reduction reaction, where there will be reduction of azide to amine. How we are going to get amine is by hydrolysis of immunophosphorine. If this immunophosphorine upon hydrolysis will lead to the formation of primary amine. Hence, this Staudinger reaction can be called as reduction reaction. The two mild reduction reaction which leads to the formation of primary amine from corresponding organic azides. The mechanism of Staudinger reaction is as follows. So first step, the initial step is attack of trivalent phosphorus to unsubstituted nitrogen atom of azide to form phosphazide. So if you take azide, it will be in resonance form, and this trivalent phosphorus is going to attack the unsubstituted nitrogen atom of azide molecule, and it leads to the formation of intermediate phosphazide. This phosphazide via 4-member transition state loses dinitrogen molecule to form immunophosphorine. So whatever the phosphazide formed, it will rearrange itself so that it is going to form a 4-member transition state. So this is the transition state, 4-member transition state. And this 4-member transition state loses dinitrogen molecule to form immunophosphorine, and this immunophosphorine finally it will undergo hydrolysis in presence of water to form corresponding primary amine. So this is the mechanism of Staudinger reaction, that is a mild reduction of organic azide to primary amine by using trialkyl or triaryl phosphine in presence of water. Now, at the beginning, I said in one reaction, we are going to study two named reactions. So, this is one named reaction, that is Staudinger reaction. So, from this immunophosphorine, we are going to see the one more named reaction, that is azavitic reaction. So, whatever the immunophosphorine, we have studied formation, that is Staudinger reaction, and it undergoes hydrolysis to give primary amine. So if the reaction of azylide, that is immunophosphorine, with various carbonyl compounds yields skiff base, that is imine derivative, and this reaction is known as azavitic reaction, and this is the reaction. Up to this step, it is Staudinger reaction. That is, organic azide will react with trialkyl, triaryl phosphine. Here, in azavitic reaction, we are going to take triphenyl phosphine. Azide, organic azide, it may be alkyl or aryl azide, reacts with triphenyl phosphine by loss of nitrogen molecule. It leads to formation of immunophosphorine. Up to this, it is Staudinger reaction. How? If this immunophosphorine reacts with various carbonyl compounds like if it is Y, it is equal to oxygen or sulfur. If oxygen is present, carbonyl, sulfur is present, thiocarbonyls. If this immunophosphorane reacts with this carbonyl compounds, then it leads to the formation of imine, that is skiff base. And this azovitic reaction, synthetically, it is very useful because it is going to form carbon nitrogen double bond. So this carbon nitrogen double bond, it is very important in the formation of heterocyclic compounds. We come for the mechanism of this azovitic reaction. Up to immunophosphorane, we have studied the mechanism how this immunophosphorane is going to form in the Staudinger reaction. Now, this immunophosphorane, how it is going to react with the carbonyl compound, we will see the mechanism. Immunophosphorines are resonance stabilized, and these are the two resonance structures for the immunophosphorane, or it is azaelide. In the first step of this azovitic reaction, what happens is nucleophilic nitrogen of immunophosphorane attacks the carbonyl group to form four-membered oxazaphosphatane intermediate. That is, in immunophosphorane, this nitrogen is nucleophilic. This nucleophilic nitrogen is going to attack the carbonyl carbon, which is electrophilic in nature, and it is going to form a four-membered intermediate, that is oxazaphosphatane. So nucleophilic nitrogen attacks this carbonyl carbon and it is going to form this type of structure. And since we know phosphorus is having affinity for oxygen, so it is going to form four-membered oxazaphosphatane. This four-membered oxazaphosphatane, because of affinity of phosphorus towards oxygen and due to formation of stable phosphorus oxygen bond, this four-membered ring will collapse to form skiff base, and byproduct will be triphenyl phosphine oxide. So this is the mechanism of azovitic reaction. So from one reaction we have learned two named reactions, that is Staudinger reaction and azovitic reaction. Thank you.